A regular viewer of my channel invited me to Turkey to discuss the possibility of using gasifiers. And I flew to Istanbul at his invitation. The population of this city is more than half of Ukraine, about 20 million. At least that's what I heard. It was very interesting to cross the bridge with the Marmara Sea on the left and the Black Sea on the right. And the air here, of course, is pleasant. I visited a large textile factory, which, by the way, supplies the entire Ukrainian army with fabric for sewing uniforms. Unfortunately, I did not film the room where the uniforms were on display. This and many other similar factories are in great need of steam, which is obtained from lignite. Fine lignite of rather poor quality, about 3,000 kilocalories per kg, is burnt there in industrial boilers. Wood has a higher caloric value of 3,500 kilocalories per kilo. There are many such factories. This particular factory burns 100 tons of coal per day. At first, I thought I could do with the wood gasifiers I mastered. But there was no such luck, there is no wood in Turkey. As we drove through the suburbs of Istanbul, it seemed to me that I was driving through the Donetsk region of Ukraine with the same step. Just like home. There are no forests here. Or very few. Therefore, I have to make a fluidized bed gasifier using lignite. The lignite here is small in size, up to 10 millimeters, and is suitable for a fluidized bed. Besides, Turkey is the fourth largest poultry producer and, as you might have guessed, theirs have plenty of manure in addition to lignite. It can also be perfectly gasified by fluidized bed gasifiers. There's also a lot of biosludge from the city sediment basins. I realized that in Turkey, you can only work with three fuels: chicken manure, low-quality lignite, and biosludge from the city sediment basins. Maybe some crushed plastic waste, too. But fate favored me, and a friend of an acquaintance of mine produces milling shredders that are just right for our tasks. He also produces belt presses for biosludge used when the sludge has to be dug out of the ground and squeezed to reduce its humidity from 90 to 60%. That entrepreneur also produces drum dryers to finish drying the fuel. That is, the whole chain of equipment required to process Turkish bed, in every sense, fuel. He has a big company, and he himself is a competent engineer. Here he showed me his workshop with a crane beam. The only device that will cope with the previously mentioned fuel types is the fluidized bed gasifier. And now I sit and design sketches for a prototype with 400 kilowatts heat capacity so that my acquaintance can build it and start testing these fuels. And also start demonstrating such a gasifier to partner textile factories and other businesses like poultry farms. Now it's just a matter of doing it all. A journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. By the way, a few more words about the factory which burns lignite. A very interesting story happened. The factory owner said that he wanted to sell his fabric to a German, but the German said that he would not buy the fabric because the product has a high carbon footprint, i.e. it is made by burning fuel which emits a lot of CO2. At the same time, if this fuel is burnt with a gasifier, there will also be hydrogen in the gas. This will improve the environmental situation because about 20% of the gas will consist of hydrogen. Gasifiers belong to green technology if they burn biomass. It's hard to say whether it would somehow relate to green technology if we gasify lignite instead of burning it. What do you think? Write in the comments. That was my little story about Turkey. See you soon.